Armando Hasurungan, biology and medicine videos. Please make sure to subscribe, join the forum and group for the latest videos. Please visit Facebook Armando Hasurungan. This video is a first part of a series of videos that will look at embryology. So we're going to begin where fertilization occurs, essentially, and implantation. So here we have the reproductive tract, the uterus, the vagina, cervix, fimbriae, and uterine tube, also known as a fallopian tube. And here, coming out of the sides attached to a ligament, are the ovaries. Ovaries are female gonads, and ovaries are what will produce the female egg, the oocyte. Women go through a cycle called the menstrual cycle each month, where they ovulate and they release an egg called an oocyte. This process is called ovulation. Here we have the oocyte, which is surrounded by a thick protective membrane called the zona pellucida. And surrounding the zona pellucida are cells with of the corona radiata. If this oocyte, this egg, is not fertilized by a male sperm, what is known as a basically period occurs. However, if there was a bit of sperm swimming along in the uterine tube, and then the sperm meets and penetrates the oocyte, this process is then known as fertilization. The sperm is able to penetrate the zona pellucida using special enzymes on its head. Anyway, once fertilization occurs, a zygote is formed. A zygote is a fertilized egg, and this is our day one. The sperm's DNA and the oocyte's DNA mix to form literally one cell. That one cell then divides into two cells. Those two cells then divide into 4, then 8, then 16. This whole process, which occurs along the fallopian, or the uterine tube, is known as cleavage. What's interesting to know is that as these cells keep dividing, the whole structure actually does not get bigger, but the number of cells increase. And so they just basically are they become compacted in the structure. And these cluster of cells are still within the zona pellucida. When there are about 16 cells clustered together in a ball, this collection of cells is known as a marola. And by this stage, it is day 4, post-fertilization. This marola will divide again and form a blastocyst, which is a collection of 32 or more cells. These cells that I'm talking about are essentially embryonic cells. So all these cells within the blastocyst are embryonic cells. The blastocyst is still surrounded by zona pellucida. The blastocyst will now implant into the growing uterine wall. The blastocyst I am drawing now is a cross-sectional view of the blastocyst. So we are cutting it in half and we're looking inside the blastocyst. So this blastocyst implants, and this is about day 7. Before the blastocyst implants, the blastocyst actually will shed the zona pellucida, which, if you remember, was the membrane surrounding the oocyte initially. In the next video, we're going to focus on implantation. Thank you.